How can you in Nutanix Calm control what users are allowed to see and launch or do to an application? My name's Chris Brown. Let's go take a look. As with any self-service product, controlling who has access to what and what their responsibilities and roles are is critical. Calm uses projects to assign roles to particular users and groups. Inside the Calm GUI, if you click on this bottom link, you go into the project view. Here you can see the projects that have been defined already, as well as any usage and quotas if assigned, as well as users and VMs assigned to this project. We can also create our own custom project or a new project for a different group of people. We give it a name and a description if we'd like. We can click on the plus user button here to assign users to this. Once we start typing, Calm will automatically search Active Directory and match. We then have to assign them a role. There are four roles available to users within a project: project admin, developer, consumer, and operator. Operators are the lowest level, and they are only allowed to run actions against existing applications. They're not allowed to launch new ones or edit any existing blueprints. Consumers can launch new blueprints from the marketplace and run actions against them, but are not allowed to create their own blueprints. Developers can do both of those in addition to creating their own blueprints. Project admins finally have full control of the project, so everything the developer can do, plus some additional reporting and user management pieces. One thing to note here is that Prism admins, while not defined here, have full access to the system. They are super users within Calm and within the rest of Prism. So they have access to this project by default. You can also assign particular groups. It doesn't need to be just a user. Maybe I need to give my engineering group full access. Now, anytime a user from the engineering group logs in, they will have access to this project as a developer. Next, I need to decide what kind of infrastructure I want to use for this project. I can choose local only, cloud only, or both. If I choose both, first I've got to select what AHV cluster I want to use for this project, and then I've got to select what network it has access to. Now, remember that a user can be a member of multiple projects at the same time, which lets you control where your applications are being deployed based on the project. For example, maybe you have a development environment and a production environment. You can have developers or your application engineers be project admins in the development environment, full control over everything, going through, making blueprints, testing it out, all of that. You can then take that blueprint once they're done and publish it to production environment where only a few people have access to, or more people have read-only access to, so that you can control what's happening in production without hamstringing people. You can also assign quotas for vCPUs, storage, and memory down here. And then since I select cloud resources, I can select a cloud account here. Remember that I can have multiple cloud accounts, which might have different regions they have access to, or different permissions, or different images available to them, or different billing. The last piece of the project configuration is the environment. This is required to launch applications from the marketplace, and is basically just the default VM configuration. The marketplace many times will download the images it needs, but for some things that we can't distribute, it needs a base image to run from instead. So you just go through here and fill out for AHV and for AWS the default size and default settings for a VM that isn't already preset from the marketplace. Be sure to check out Portal for the Calm Operations Guide for full information on what each role has permissions to do, as well as more information on environment and other settings you can do here in projects. In order to publish a blueprint to the marketplace, there's a few steps you need to do. First, go to the Blueprints view in Calm. Then, go to the blueprint you'd like to publish. Once in the blueprint, you simply need to click this Publish link. Blueprint gets prepared, and then we need to give it a name. And then we can give it a description. This description can be written in Markdown, and you can use this little I here to change what it looks like. So for example, you can write out a quick variables guide. We see that this is what it'll look like when published. I can now publish it. The blueprint is now awaiting approval from an administrator. The administrator can go over here to the Marketplace Manager, and then to Approval Pending. We see that blueprint here. They can click on it, take a look at it, maybe launch it, make sure it works, verify it, whatever their process needs to be, and then approve it or reject it. Once approved, it goes over here under Marketplace Blueprints. We can search for it. And we see here this blueprint. Next, we've got to choose a category if we'd like so that it can be filtered later on, and choose the projects we want to share it with. So for example, maybe I want to share this with engineering, apply. And publish. When you publish the blueprint, it just publishes it locally to your Calm instance. It's not sending it out to anyone else. We now see that the status of this blueprint is published as opposed to just accepted. Now, since I published it to the engineering group, and let's also publish it to the default group. Using this, we can change who's allowed to see it and who can use it. If we go up now to the marketplace, we see here that blueprint we just published and who published it. We see the markdown code we put in there, and we can also verify the actions. At this point, we can treat it like any other marketplace blueprint. So that's how you make projects, assign them quotas, assign users to projects, and publish blueprints to that project's marketplace. As you can see, we tried to make it very simple, very straightforward, and easy to use while still being fully functional. Thank you guys so much for joining us today. This is actually the last video in our Calm series, so we hope you guys learned a lot and enjoyed the series. If there's anything we missed or anything you'd like to see more about Calm, let us know in the comments below. Thanks everyone, and have a great day.